Good morning. So, today's, we're in the house. We was busy yesterday. We ended up making a road trip and getting Marcia a couch. So, sitting here looking at this thing and reading it, the word enmity is in it again. And that meant the opposition, the word enmity.
Don't ask me. You want to street me
out? Enmity. Enmity. And verse 16 is where we're at today. And it says, and should be reconciling both in one body to God through the cross, killing the enmity in it. So I didn't know, you know, the killing the enmity, these words, you know, I don't recognize the meaning of them. And so Marcia just looked it up, and it was opposition, right? It was opposition. So
actively
opposition. So I looked, I thought, well, that's opposing. So what is this that he's killing the enmity in? Well, let's go up a little bit. So nullifying the law of precepts and degrees, that he should be creating the two into one humanity, making peace, and should be reconciling both in one body to God through the cross, killing the enmity in it, the opposition. So I thought, well, that's tied in here to Galatians 5:16 and 17 says, now I am saying, walk in spirit, and you should under no circumstances be consummating the lust of the flesh. For the flesh is lusting against the spirit, yet the spirit against the flesh. Now these are opposing one another. So this is opposition. The lusting, the spirit and the flesh are opposing one another. That's enmity. That's what it means. So let's look at this, how these references come out. let's see what we got. And he should be reconciling both in one body through the cross, killing the enmity in it. Which in other generations is not made known to the sons of humanity, as it was now revealed to his holy apostles and prophets. In spirit, the nations are to be joint enjoyers of an allotment and a joint body, and joint partakers of the promise in Christ Jesus through the evangel. I got some coffee. Y'all getting up and around?
Mama make coffee.
Yeah, Marcia, man, she made some good coffee. One body and one spirit, according as you were called also with one expectation of your calling, one Lord, one faith, one baptism, one God and Father of all, who is over all and through all and in all. For if being enemies, we were conciliated to God through the death of his Son, much rather, being conciliated, we shall be saved in his life. Yet not only so, but we are glorying also in God through our Lord Jesus Christ, through whom we now obtain the conciliation. You know, you never heard that stuff in church. That we were enemies, that we was conciliated through the death of his Son. Yeah. Yet all is of God, who conciliates us to himself through Christ, and is giving us the dispensation of the conciliation. How that God was in Christ, conciliating the world to himself, not reckoning their offenses to them, and placing in us the word of the conciliation. For Christ, then, are we ambassadors, as of God entreating through us. We are beseeching, for Christ's sake, be conciliated to God. For the one not knowing sin, he makes to be a sin offering for our sakes, that we may be becoming God's righteousness in him. For in him the entire complement delights to dwell, and through him to reconcile all to him, making peace through the blood of his cross. Through him, whether those on the earth or those in the heavens. And you, being once estranged and enemies in comprehension by wicked acts, yet now he reconciles by his body of flesh, through his death, to present you holy and flawless and unimpeachable in his sight. For he is our peace, who makes both one and razes the central wall of the barrier, the enmity in his flesh, nullifying the law of precepts, that he should be creating the two in himself into one humanity, making peace, and should be reconciling both in one body to God through the cross, killing the enmities in it. Knowing this, that our old humanity was crucified together with him, that the body of sin may be nullified, for us by no means to be still slaving for sin. For one who dies has been justified from sin. Nothing, consequently, is now condemnation to those in Christ Jesus, not according to flesh are they walking, but according to spirit. For the Spirit's law of life in Christ Jesus frees you from the law of sin and death. For what was impossible to the law, in which it was infirm through the flesh, did God, sending his own Son in the likeness of sin's flesh. And concerning sin, he condemns sin in the flesh, that the just requirements of the law may be fulfilled in us, who are not walking in accord with flesh, but in accord with spirit. For the disposition of the flesh is death, yet the disposition of spirit is life and peace. Because the disposition of the flesh is enmity to God, for it is not subject to the law of God, for neither is it able. Now those who are in flesh are not able to please God, yet you are not in flesh, but in spirit. If so be that God's spirit is making its home in you. Now, if anyone has not Christ's spirit, this one is not his. With Christ have I been crucified. Yet I am living. No longer I, but living in me is Christ. Now, that which I am now living in flesh, I am living in faith that is of the Son of God, who loves me and gives himself up for me. Being entombed together with him in baptism, in whom you were roused together also through faith in the operation of God, who rouses him from among the dead, you also, being dead to the offenses and the uncircumcision of your flesh, he vivifies us together jointly with him, dealing graciously with all our offenses, erasing the handwriting of the decrees against us, which was hostile to us, and has taken it away out of the midst, nailing it to the cross, stripping off the sovereignties and the authorities with boldness. He makes a show of them, triumphing over them in it. Wow.
He's always going to triumph.
Triumphing, yeah. We can't add to that. Wow. Yeah. Man, that's some that's some good stuff. Yeah, if that don't get you going, your wood's wet. I'm just talking about it for me. Stuff like that. I mean, there's some powerful stuff in that. But anyway, It's cold outside.
No, it's not.
It is. You step your little self out there and you say, "Woohoo! This is cool out here."
Well, it stormed last night.
Oh, did it? I don't know if it.
Yeah. The thunder rolled last night.
And the thunder rolled. There's a song. That's a song, isn't it? And the thunder rolled. We don't listen to much music.
No.
Some of the old stuff we enjoyed. But after getting into religious music, that ruined us. It ruined me. I can't. The religious, and because back in the, they said, well, you know, you can't. Rock and roll, that stuff is there wasn't any good stuff in it.
It was the devil's music. And come to find out. The things we learned.
Yeah, and now we understand so much more. Things has got so much more clear. Man.
It's loverly.
Yeah. That's a made-up word, ain't it?
Yeah.
You want to explain it, no. That word?
No. I'm fine.
Oh, there goes the clock.
Marcia woke up in a sassy mood today.
Oh, it's going to be a good day. I love it when she's sassy. It's awesome. We have a lot of fun, Marcia and I do.
I've got a lot of making up. Aggravating you today. Ladies, there's nothing like being in the bathroom, doing your business, and some person comes and thumps on the door really hard.
On that door.
Yeah.
That'll stir you up. Yeah, well, yeah, I've probably been a little ornery. Oh, well.
There's been several really
ornery. Has there? Several. You've been counting, keeping track?
Yeah.
You ain't supposed to do that. Anyway, it's been a good day. We're going to be in a good evening tonight, morning. It's morning. This is morning time. What is it? 4:30 in the morning. We better get this thing up. All right. Let's go see what God's got.
We love you.
Yeah, we love you. Appreciate you hanging out. And we'll talk to you tomorrow. Grace and peace. See you tomorrow.